praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to give thanks unto the Lord for this pregnant woman who is listening to this prayer CD. I want you to know that this is the day that the Lord has made for you. You must rejoice and be glad in it. It is a thing of joy for you to be blessed of the Almighty God with this bundle of joy inside of you. For you to be pregnant is a great privilege from God. I'm sure you yourself, you are very happy that God has made you well. Out of all the women in the whole world, God has favored you by making you pregnant. You need to really appreciate God because He has done you well. And that is why I want you to sing this song along with me. God is good. He has done me well. Oh, my soul, rise up and praise the Lord. God is good. He has done me well. Oh, my soul, rise up and praise the Lord. You need to thank the Lord for bringing you to the stage of being an expectant mother, a mother carrying a bundle of joy inside of her. I want you to know, in accordance with the word of the Lord, in 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15, that says, nevertheless, she shall be saved in childbearing if she continues in faith, love, holiness with self-control. The four major keywords here are faith, love, holiness, and self-control. God is expecting you to put your faith online as we are carrying this bundle of joy inside of you. Your faith must be up. You must rejoice in the Lord. You must stay holy. You must put in self-control. Because once you do all those things, God is going to make you safe in childbearing. I want you to know that it is the will of God for you to be pregnant. It is equally the will of God for you to carry that pregnancy safely and deliver the bundle of joy at the appointed time. You remember the Hebrew women in their days. God gave them this favor to be pregnant and to deliver before the nurses could attend to them. There was a time a decree went forth that all the male children should be killed by the nurses. But the power of God was available for the Hebrew women to deliver before the nurses could get there. I see that same power resting upon you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, just like that Hebrew woman in her days. You're going to deliver within a few minutes in the name of Jesus. I want you to know that prayers are very, very important as at the time of carrying your pregnancy, as at the time of going through your labor, and as at the time of delivery. Prayers are needed to guide against any form of mishap, any form of miscarriage. And that is why I want you to go along with me as I pray the following prayers. That the Lord, who has started a good work of creation in you, will complete it until the day of Christ in Jesus' name. I plead the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth upon you, upon the baby in your womb, upon your husband, in the name of Jesus. Every part of your body is soaked inside the pool of the blood of Jesus, your womb, the placenta, the baby, every part of your body. I want you to know that as you are carrying this baby in your womb, it is very important to seek for medical attention at the appropriate hospital. But I want you to pray the following prayers along with me. You must be in a complete agreement, because the Holy Spirit is going to take you through and all will be well with you in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I soak your entire body inside the pool of the blood of the Lamb in the name of Jesus. Let every part of your body function perfectly during this pregnancy in the name of Jesus. Your blood shall be rich with all the nutrients needed for the baby. In the name of Jesus, you shall be effective during pregnancy in the precious name of Jesus. O Lord God, I pray for this, your daughter, with the baby inside of her, that there shall not be any manipulation at any point in the name of Jesus. During the formation of this baby, during the time of development, this baby shall receive the touch of God. Every part of the baby shall develop normally in the name of Jesus. You, the mother, shall be strong. You shall not be weak in the name of Jesus. Sickness will not be your lot during pregnancy in the name of Jesus. And during this pregnancy, that vomiting and early morning sickness, I command them to disappear from your life in the name of Jesus. I raise the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth against those cramps, varicose veins attacks, pile, back pains, constipation, anemia. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that swollen feet will not be there in Jesus' name. There shall not be any form of hypertension. In the name of Jesus, diabetes will not attack you. No convulsion, no hormonal imbalance. In the name of Jesus, I raise the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth against activities of eaters of flesh and drinkers of blood during this, your pregnancy, in the name of Jesus. Even after this pregnancy, after you have delivered, attacks will not come upon you in the name of Jesus. Any form of negative dream that may want to cause havoc to the baby inside of you, that may want to threaten your life, that negative dream is hereby canceled in Jesus' name. Had there been any prophecy or prediction, had there been any evil imagination against you, against this baby, during pregnancy, as at the time of delivery, and after delivery, I ask the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth to neutralize and cancel those negative dreams, prophecies, and predictions, and evil imagination in the name of Jesus. And I make a decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, woman, you will not miscarry this baby in the name of Jesus. You will not miscarry this baby in Jesus' name. Any form of abnormal bleeding is hereby rebuked in the name of Jesus. Your pregnancy is established in righteousness in the name of Jesus. And I decree upon you that as you are carrying this pregnancy, no evil shall befall you or your baby in the name of Jesus. No plague around you, no plague in your home. Wherever you may be, there is no plague in the name of Jesus. And I decree in the name of Jesus that you shall now have premature delivery in Jesus' name. The number of your days you shall fulfill in Jesus' name. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that no medical worker shall manipulate this pregnancy in Jesus' name. And you will not register in a wrong hospital in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Lord has given you this baby. The angels of the Lord will assist you in childbearing, in carrying this pregnancy, in childbearing, in the name of Jesus. Demonic doctors and midwives will not be on duty as at the time of delivering in Jesus' name. I ask in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that prolonged labor and delayed delivery will not be your lot in Jesus' name. I decree in the name of Jesus that complication that may want to arise during pregnancy and as at the time of delivery is hereby neutralized by the power and in the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, your pelvis shall be wide enough to allow the baby out in the name of Jesus. Everything in your body will cooperate with easy delivery in Jesus' name. I speak forth into your hormones in the name of Jesus to receive the power of the Holy Ghost. I speak forth into your uterus, the uterine lining, the amniotic sac, the amniotic fluid, the cervix, everything in you to cooperate in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth during and after pregnancy in Jesus' name. And as at the time of delivery, the voice of the Lord that is full of power and majesty, the voice of the Lord that thundereth over the waters, the voice of the Lord that makes the deer to give birth, will send adequate signal to your brain, to your hormones, and that signal will flow to the baby inside of you. The head of the baby will be down, the legs will be up, the placenta will be clearly above the legs of the baby, and as at that time of delivery, the voice of the Lord will instruct your uterine lining to begin to contract normally, and the voice of the Lord will send a signal to your cervix to dilate accordingly. And as at the time that the baby must come out, the voice of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth will send a signal to the amniotic sac to break loose and release the amniotic fluid. And the amniotic fluid in the name of Jesus shall be thick and warm enough to lubricate your passage. And as at the time that the voice of the Lord sends a signal to the baby to come out, the baby will come out within 30 minutes of grace in the name of Jesus. These prophecies shall take over you, take over your baby, and you're going to give glory unto the Lord. In the name of Jesus, the Lord shall supply all your needs during this pregnancy and the needs of this baby in the name of Jesus. And I make a decree in the name of Jesus that at the end of the day, you shall be a joyful mother in Jesus' name. Beloved, I want you to know that you need to really pray to take care of many things that you may experience during pregnancy and as at the time of delivery and after delivery. And that is why I want to run you through this prayer session. This prayer CD is specially made for you because God loves you. God loves his deposit inside of you. Now, we are going into a marathon session of prayers, and I want you to flow along. And I believe that at the end of the day, you are going to thank the Lord in the name of Jesus. Now, I want you to sing this song along with me. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood, in the blood. There is power mighty in the blood of Jesus Christ. There is power mighty in the blood. Amen. Now, I ask in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that the Lord will show you mercy during this pregnancy. In the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus will avail for you. In the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus will be upon every department of your body, every department of that baby that is forming inside of you. As the baby is forming, the blood of Jesus will saturate every nook and cranny of that baby. The blood of Jesus will saturate every part of that baby in the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus that every demonic instrument of operation set aside to abort a pregnancy shall be destroyed by fire in the name of Jesus. That demonic weapon fashioned against this pregnancy shall not prosper in accordance with the word of the Lord that says in Isaiah 54 verse 17 that no weapon fashioned against you and your baby and your husband shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Any tongue that rises against you during this pregnancy and as at the time of delivery and after delivery shall be condemned in Jesus' name. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that any demonic medical worker, whether a demonic doctor, a demonic nurse, a demonic hospital worker delegated by the devil to tamper with your pregnancy, shall be arrested in the name of Jesus. Shall be arrested in the name of Jesus. I decree upon you that the blood of Jesus will cover you, will cover your baby, will cover your husband, will cover your home, so that the arrows of the enemies will not strike you. In the name of Jesus, every evil remote controlling gadget that the enemies may want to use to manipulate this pregnancy shall be roasted by fire. And in the name of Jesus, any gadget of the enemy that had been prepared to cause manipulation during this pregnancy, I command that gadget to be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Let it be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. Let it be roasted by fire in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus that the man of war in heaven, Jehovah, the man of war, we save you, your baby, and your husband out of the hand of the wicked people in the name of Jesus. And I equally decree that the man of war in heaven will save you out of the hands of wicked midwives, wicked doctors in the name of Jesus. Only the right doctors, the right nurses, the right medical workers shall be there to minister to you in the name of Jesus. I close down every satanic broadcasting station fashioned against your pregnancy, where they may want to be announcing evil concerning this pregnancy, in the name of Jesus. The Lord will close down that broadcasting station in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree upon you that you will see the great work of the Lord in the land of the living as you deliver this baby safely in Jesus' name. Now hear this, and I want you to say a big amen. Your life will not cooperate with any pregnancy killer in the name of Jesus. Your life will not cooperate with any pregnancy destroyer in the name of Jesus. Your life will not cooperate with any pregnancy waster and emptier in the name of Jesus. Your life will not cooperate with any pregnancy destroyer and spoiler in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that spirit of error will not come in during your pregnancy, during your delivery, and after delivery in the name of Jesus. I reject any negative medical diagnosis that may want to tamper with your life and the life of your baby in the name of Jesus. The Lord will minister to the doctor to know the right thing to do. The Lord will minister to that matron. The Lord will minister to that nurse to know what to do at the right time in the name of Jesus. And I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that the light of God is going to illuminate you, illuminate that baby, illuminate your womb in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 4:18 says that the path of the just is as a shining light, shining more and more unto a perfect day. When light of God appears, darkness disappears. And I decree in the name of Jesus that every patch of darkness around you must disappear now. In the name of Jesus, let the light of God illuminate you, illuminate your baby. In the name of Jesus, I break every grip and every hold of any witchcraft power over this pregnancy in the name of Jesus. Witchcraft has no place in this pregnancy in the name of Jesus, because this pregnancy belongs to God. God is the controller of this pregnancy. Every grip of witchcraft is hereby destroyed in the name of Jesus. As from today, I make a decree in accordance with the word of the Lord that you will not cast your young in the name of Jesus. The one inside of you, the bundle of joy, shall grow unto maturity, shall be delivered at the appropriate time in the name of Jesus. Hear this and say a big amen to this. Every opposition to your pregnancy and delivery is hereby destroyed in the name of Jesus. I raise the blood of Jesus as a standard against any opposition to this pregnancy, to your delivery, in the name of Jesus. That opposition is hereby canceled in the name of Jesus. You will fulfill the number of the days of this pregnancy in the name of Jesus. Any member of your family reporting your pregnancy to any evil coven, any member of your household reporting this pregnancy to the dark powers, any member among your associates that may want to report this pregnancy to the evil ones where you are working, where you are living, in your environment, in the dark kingdom, let the law hinder that member in the name of Jesus. That report will not come to pass. I'm decreeing upon you afresh. The negative reports are hereby rejected concerning your pregnancy and delivery in Jesus' name. Can I hear your loud amen? Negative reports are hereby rejected in the name of Jesus. Concerning this pregnancy, there shall not be any negative report. Only good reports shall be given unto you in the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that before the date of delivery, this baby will not be aborted in Jesus' name. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that if there is any territorial demon working against your pregnancy, let that territorial demon receive the thunder of fire in the name of Jesus. Hear this and say a big amen. Every spirit of stillbirth, every spirit of threatened abortion, is hereby arrested in the name of Jesus. That spirit of stillbirth will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, that spirit of threatened abortion will not prosper. In the name of Jesus, I ask in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that dark murderers, those in the dark kingdom that are murderers and assassins, murdering babies that are coming to life, murdering their mothers, they will not have any place in this pregnancy in Jesus' name. So I raise the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth against pregnancy murderers and assassins in the name of Jesus. They shall not have any place in your life, in the life of your baby, in the name of Jesus. This one is very, very important. Any power, any spirit visiting you at night or in your dream in order to terminate your pregnancy shall be arrested in the name of Jesus. If there is any delegated spirit from the kingdom of darkness, if there is any delegated power from the kingdom of darkness assigned to visit you at night or in your dream in order to manipulate this pregnancy, in order to lock up this pregnancy, in order to terminate this pregnancy, such power, such spirit is hereby arrested in the name of Jesus. Let the power in the blood of Jesus hinder this dark power in the name of Jesus. In your dream, you shall have victory in the name of Jesus. They will not manipulate your pregnancy through dreams in the name of Jesus. The Holy Spirit will be with you in the night and in your dream in the name of Jesus to wash over this pregnancy, to wash over you, to wash over your baby, to wash over your husband in the name of Jesus. I nullify every influence of satanic visitation upon this pregnancy in the name of Jesus. Any strange influence of satanic visitation, whether during the day, in the noon, in the evening, in the midnight, as per this pregnancy, that strange influence of satanic visitation is hereby nullified by the power in the blood of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. The Lord will deliver your womb from any form of miscarriage, in the name of Jesus. I decree and I pray this prayer with emphasis, in the name of Jesus, that the Lord God Almighty will release his power to shield your baby from any assault, any spiritual assault, in the name of Jesus. And the Lord God Almighty, at the point of delivery, will release his overwhelming power over you to be able to deliver under the influence of the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that any form of spiritual violence that may want to arise during this pregnancy and as the time of delivery is hereby neutralized and cancelled in Jesus' name. Every manifestation of fever, every manifestation of any disease associated medically with pregnancy is hereby neutralized and nullified by the blood of the Lamb in the name of Jesus. He has made your body. Remember Jeremiah 32, 17. Our Lord God, thou hast made the heavens and the earth by thy great power. Our Lord God, thou hast made the heavens and the earth by thy arm stretched out. Nothing is too difficult for thee. Nothing is too difficult for thee. Great and mighty God. Great in counsel and mighty indeed, you are mighty indeed. Nothing, absolutely nothing is too difficult for thee. Remember verse 27 of Jeremiah 32 that says that, behold, I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? Now, if you believe in the word of God in that Jeremiah 32, verses 17 and 27, then you must say a big amen to this prayer. I decree that every body part of yours shall be intact throughout this pregnancy, as at the time of delivery, and thereafter in the name of Jesus. Nothing shall tamper with your body parts and with the body part of that fetus in your womb in the name of Jesus. The God of all flesh will supply every needed vitamin, every needed nutrient in the name of Jesus. The God of all flesh will preserve your flesh, will preserve your spirit, your soul, the spirit, the soul, and the flesh of that baby in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that you, that baby in the womb, you shall not be aborted in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now, say a big amen to this prayer. Throughout the period of pregnancy, you shall not be stressed in the name of Jesus. You shall not be distressed in the name of Jesus. You shall not be confused in the name of Jesus. You shall not be manipulated in the name of Jesus. You shall not be maneuvered by the enemy in the name of Jesus. You shall not be overwhelmed with any strange feeling in the name of Jesus. There shall be angelic ministration throughout this pregnancy, as at the time of delivery, and thereafter in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus that your body shall be strong enough by the power of the Holy Ghost to carry this baby, to labor, and to give birth, and to nurture the baby inside of you. In the name of Jesus, the Lord God will send his heavenly nurses to minister to you throughout this period of pregnancy and as time of delivery in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus that you will bring forth a normal baby in the name of Jesus. And if perhaps you are carrying multiple babies, you are going to give birth to multiple babies that are well formed in the name of Jesus. Normal children, normal babies, in the name of Jesus. And you are going to shout hallelujah at the end of the day in the precious name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I decree that your cervix, as you are listening to me, shall be closed up. There shall not be any contraction or dilation before the 9 months period. In the name of Jesus, cervix, you will open in the name of Jesus, and you will allow the baby out. There shall be proper contraction and dilation as at the due day that this woman shall give birth in the name of Jesus. And I ask in the name of Jesus that the power of God from on high shall be upon you as at the time you are to deliver in Jesus' name. I decree in the name of Jesus that every horn of the wicked raised against you and that baby will not prosper in the name of Jesus. The Lord will cut off the horns of the wicked in Jesus' name. Now, hear this prayer. You will not labor in vain in the name of Jesus. As at the time of carrying this pregnancy, is a time of a labor, so to say. So, you will not carry this pregnancy in vain. You will not labor in vain in Jesus' name. As at the time of delivery, that you are going to have that childbirth labor, you will not labor in vain in the name of Jesus. A dead child shall not be brought out of you in Jesus' name. And a living child shall not be brought out of a dead mother in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, if you are carrying multiple babies, dead children will not be carried out of a living mother in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, living children shall not be carried out of a dead mother in Jesus' name. You will not be killed. Your baby or your babies will not be killed in the name of Jesus. The Lord will preserve you, will preserve your baby in the name of Jesus. And I ask in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that you and that baby in your womb shall be for signs and wonders in the name of Jesus. I speak forth to this baby in your womb that this baby, as at the time the baby is in the womb, shall be delivered from any form of womb attacks in Jesus' name. Shall be delivered from any foundational challenges in the name of Jesus. If there's any foundational challenge that may want to trouble this baby, thereafter, when the baby comes to life, I raise the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth against that foundational challenge in the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus that the good virtues inside the father of this baby and the good virtues inside the mother of this baby will combine together to manifest inside the life of this baby in the name of Jesus. No evil shall be transferred to this baby in the name of Jesus, in the womb and thereafter in Jesus' name. I decree in the name of Jesus, woman, as you are experiencing biological and emotional changes, let the joy of the Lord be your strength in the name of Jesus. There are a lot of changes happening to you now. Emotional changes, biological changes, I decree that the joy of the Lord shall be your strength in the name of Jesus. Sing this song with me. The joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 The joy of the Lord is your strength in the name of Jesus. I ask that the divine fire of God, we envelope that baby inside of you and we envelope you also in the name of Jesus. The divine fire of the Lord will barricade your life and the life of that baby. Just the way the mountains surround Jerusalem, let the Lord barricade your life and the life of that baby with divine fire, so that evil observers will not see you and that baby in the name of Jesus, so that you will not be monitored for evil in the name of Jesus. The Lord will give you heavenly care and proper development for that baby in the name of Jesus. The one who had made you to be a joyful carrier of that baby, we see you too in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, during the morning time, there shall not be any complication. In the afternoon, in the evening, in the midnight, in the name of Jesus. No defect inside that baby, in the name of Jesus. You are giving birth to a perfect baby. Can you say a big amen to that? In the name of Jesus, the Lord will frustrate any action that the enemies might want to raise up in the name of Jesus. It is well with you. It is well with that baby in the name of Jesus. I pray this prayer for you in the name of Jesus. If there is any negative medical report that you have been given, let that negative medical report be converted to normal findings in Jesus' name. Remember Lamentation 3:37. Lamentation 3:37. It says that, who is he that says a thing and it comes to pass when the Lord has not commanded it? Now, the medical doctors are good people. God has created them. He has given them that knowledge. The medical doctors worldwide rely on God. And where that the knowledge of that medical doctor stops, God starts. There may be any abnormality discovered medically, but God has the ability to convert that finding into his own will. He will make it well. Remember that he's the potter. He molds the clay. And Jeremiah 18:1-6, if you read it, that the potter is able to remold the clay. The potter is able to remold the clay into another vessel as seems good in the name of Jesus. I take that one again. In Jeremiah 18:1-6, the Bible makes it known that God is the potter. You are the clay. The baby in your womb is the clay. The potter has the ability to remold the clay into another vessel as seems good to him to make him. So he can make it normal. He can make that medical report normal. So I want you to know that that negative medical report is not the final end of this pregnancy. God will convert it to normal findings in the name of Jesus. Any medical diagnosis that is not pleasant, any medical prognosis, let the blood of Jesus cancel it in the name of Jesus. You will have a normal delivery to the glory of God in the name of Jesus. The potter is at work. The molder of your life is at work. The molder of the life of that baby is at work in the name of Jesus. Now say amen to this prayer. Let the blood of Jesus flush out any satanic deposit in that womb in the name of Jesus. If the deposit is there in form of any growth, if it's there in form of fibroid, if it's there in form of any evil plantation, now I decree with their roots and tentacles, let the fire of God melt those deposits in the name of Jesus. It is written in the word of the Lord in Psalm 18 verses 44 and 45. As soon as they hear my voice, they must obey me and submit themselves unto me. The strangers shall fade away and they shall run out of their hiding places. Matthew 15, 13, the axe is laid upon the root of any tree that does not bear good fruit, it shall be hewn down and cast into the fire. Matthew 3, 10, any tree that my heavenly Father has not planted shall be rooted out. So anything that God has not planted in that womb, let the Lord root it out now in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, and let that womb be liberated in Jesus' name. That baby will not be disturbed by any deposit that is not of God in the name of Jesus. I charge every hand, every bed, every test with the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth in the name of Jesus. I charge every hand with Holy Ghost fire that will touch your pregnancy. I charge every hand that will touch your baby with Holy Ghost fire in the name of Jesus. That bed that you will lie on, I charge it by fire in the name of Jesus. Every test that will be conducted, I charge it by fire and by the blood of the Lamb in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that anything on your way to the miracle of supernatural conception and delivery, that thing that may want to disturb it shall be removed in Jesus' name. Anything that may want to disturb your supernatural conception and delivery, let that thing be removed in the name of Jesus. I ask in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that your womb and your breast will function normally in the name of Jesus. Your womb, your breast will function normally in the name of Jesus. The breast had been prepared for your baby to suck. The milk inside is anointed. In the name of Jesus, it shall provide nourishment to that baby. As the baby sucks that breast, when the baby is out, the baby will grow gracefully in the name of Jesus. Thou creative power of the Almighty God, move in that womb by your fire in the name of Jesus. The creative power of God, let it overwhelm that baby to create a complete baby, a brilliant baby, an anointed baby, a baby that will do excellent things in life, a baby full of witty invention in the name of Jesus, a baby anointed from the womb in the name of Jesus. I withdraw this pregnancy from any evil altar in the name of Jesus. Let this pregnancy be connected to the altar of the Lamb in heaven in the name of Jesus. Let every seed of pregnancy failure in your foundation be removed in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus, if there is any satanic transfer or exchange planned for this pregnancy, it shall not prosper. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit will make this womb super conducive for pregnancy, for that baby in the name of Jesus. It is well with your baby in the name of Jesus. I bind and arrest every infection in the name of Jesus. Your baby will not be infected in Jesus' name. You will not be infected in the name of Jesus. It shall be well with you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you will not be tired in Jesus' name. Receive strength now. In the name of Jesus, 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 I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that stamina, vigor, vitality that can only come from God. We overwhelm you in Jesus' name. Let the Lord inoculate your system, inject your system, immunize your system with vitality from heaven. In the name of Jesus, receive the breath of God. In the name of Jesus, let the breath of God, the Zoe, permeate you now, permeate that baby. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, where you go for your medical treatment, let the breath of God saturate that place in the name of Jesus. Where you are now, in that room, in that office, let the presence of the Lord be mighty in the name of Jesus. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that the anointing of fire will soak you and that baby in the name of Jesus. Right from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, let the overwhelming presence of God begin to flow now in the name of Jesus. Flow to that baby in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And I decree upon you that the mark of Calvary is upon you. Galatians 6:17 says, from this time henceforth, let no man or woman trouble you, for you bear on your body the mark of our Lord Jesus Christ. That mark of our Lord Jesus Christ is upon you, upon your pregnancy, upon your baby in Jesus' name. Reject evil laying on of hands in Jesus' name. If there is any strange hand ever laid upon your head, upon your pregnancy, that may want to tamper with that baby or tamper with your life, let the effect be canceled in the name of Jesus. Let that effect be canceled in the name of Jesus. All those negative dreams will not come to pass in Jesus' name. Only the good dreams that you are having or that you have had will come to pass in the name of Jesus. I release you on the hands of the Almighty God, that as you are in his hands, you are saved. Because the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is saved. Now it's your strong tower, it's your refuge, it's your buckler, it's your fortress. In him you live, you move, you have your being with that baby. It shall be well with you in Jesus' name. Now hear this, as at the time you are going into the hospital, just be giving thanks unto the Lord and begin to sing, God is good, he has done me well, oh my soul, rise up and praise the Lord. God is good, God is good, he has done me well, oh my soul, rise up and praise the Lord. He's good to you, he's going to be good to you to the end in the name of Jesus. He can never, never fail. He cannot fail you. I want you to get it born in your heart that God cannot fail you in pregnancy. God cannot fail you as at the time of delivery. And after delivery, God cannot fail you. You can't run mad after delivery. No attack on you after delivery. No attack on your baby after delivery in the name of Jesus. No attack on your husband in the name of Jesus. When you give back to this baby, your husband will not die in exchange in Jesus' name. You will not be exchanged for this baby. Your husband will not be exchanged for this baby. In the name of Jesus, you and your husband shall look at your baby and you shall rejoice in the name of Jesus. You will carry your baby in your hand and you will rejoice and dance unto the Lord in the name of Jesus. I want you to know that the blood of Jesus is upon you, upon your household. At the end of the day, you are going to rejoice. In the name of Jesus, you will rejoice. In the name of Jesus, you will rejoice. In the name of Jesus, now listen to this song. Super blood of Jesus, come and deliver me. The blood that flows from Calvary, come and deliver me. Super blood of Jesus, super blood of Jesus, come and deliver me. The blood that flows from Calvary, come and deliver me. That is the song you must be singing when you are on that bed and the doctor is saying it is time to bring forth your baby. In your heart, just begin to meditate on that song. Super blood of Jesus, come and deliver me. The blood that flows from Calvary, come and deliver me. As you meditate on the power in the blood of Jesus, the overwhelming presence of the Holy Spirit will be all around you and in you, in that baby. Before you can say Jesus is Lord, under 30 minutes of grace, your baby will come out. And if you are carrying multiple babies, your babies will come out in the name of Jesus. And at the end of the day, by the time you see that baby, you will shout hallelujah, Jesus is Lord. I wish you well in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And I pray for all the medical workers that I shall be well with them in Jesus' name. Now, those of you attending fellowship where they minister to pregnant women, I decree in the name of Jesus that the power of the Lord will remain and abide with that fellowship in Jesus' name. The pregnant women coordinator there shall receive fresh fire and discerning spirit to be able to know what to do in the name of Jesus. All those that God had assigned to walk along shall receive fresh fire and fresh baptism of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. That place shall be an abode of God, a Bethel of God in the name of Jesus. And I decree that those who are laboring over pregnant women, the Lord will reward them in the name of Jesus. Because Christ lives, you will live, your baby will live, your husband will live in the name of Jesus. I wish you well in the name of Jesus. Know that you need to give your testimony after your delivery that God has done it. If you have been blessed by this prayer CD, I want you to please get in contact with me, Pastor Wole Oladiyun. I'm the senior pastor of Christ Living Spring Apostolic Ministry, otherwise known as CLAM, C-L-A-M. Our church is located in Omale, Ikeja, Lagos, Nigeria. And I want you to know that your testimony will encourage others. Make sure you get this tape and give others so that they can benefit from this ministration in Jesus' name. My email address is pastorclam@yahoo.com. pastorclam@yahoo.com. My phone number is 080-5030-5030. 080-5030-5030. For those of you that may want to call us in Nigeria, plus 234-080-5030-5030. 'Cause he lives, I can't fail tomorrow.